Wow, and a great first long serve by Chengmeng. Right off the bat, immediately surprising Wang Menyu.
But Chengmeng, if she does win here, that will be history making. The reason being, she has already won this title 3 times in a row in the past, including last year. That's quite an honor already. But if she can make it this time, and she'll be for the 4th time in a row to win this title. And no man, no women, none of them has ever done that. That will be epoch making, history making.
Absolutely.
But can she really pass this young lady right here? We shall see. And of course, Wang Manyu thinks otherwise. She certainly would like to make her presence strongly felt on such a big occasion. That will be her first rogue title at this level. Oh, too short, really. But experience-wise, you would say that Chen definitely is on top of that.
I think so, yeah. Chengmeng has, I think, a few extra years under her belt. I think she'll know how to handle herself better in those crucial moments.
Mm-hmm. Yep, backhand exchange, right down the middle.
Chengmeng really finding Wang Menyu's middle there. Wang Menyu is so tall, you know, she's so quick to cover the edges and the corners of the table. But if you can jam her up and then bring her out wide, that's when you have the opportunity to strike.
Yeah, as you said, you know, she could reach out, but not the second one. Chengmeng really placed the ball very wisely.
Absolutely. Chengmeng's placement is so precise, so completely wide, even hard for Wang Menyu to reach that.
In the middle of her 20s, Chen really would like to go to the Olympics. So on these big occasions, she would never, ever let all these opportunities slip through her fingers. I mean, these are all the chances. She would like to let the squad know that she is ready. And I do believe that Lily, actually, after being coached by Ma Ling now, the former Olympic champion, she's really improving tremendously. You know, Ma Ling, we know that it's really, we call Ma Ling in the past the master of table tennis, especially with his, you know, short serves and also placement of the ball, everything.
Totally, yeah. He's a very tricky player, you know. Such great feeling, and I think Chengmeng, you know, being able to pick his brain for a lot of those crucial moments is incredibly
impressive. What a response there by Chengmeng. So ready for that.
I mean, she was already so far away from the table, but suddenly still finding something in herself to play it right down the line parallel.
Well, Wang Menyu trying very hard, reaching out, but failed. Well, she dares to really serve long, you know, whenever she thinks it is a time.
Right. It was a service mistake, but, you know, a really smart tactic by Chengmeng, actually.
Mm-hmm. Going after her opponent. Short one. Looks like she's got all the answers ready for her opponent.
She's so rock solid out there, just like a wall. You really can't get anything past her.
You know, this reminds me so much of what happened yesterday with Shasha, remember? And Sun Yinsha, not that she did a bad job, as she herself said, it's just that Chengmeng was so solid with her defense.
Right, yeah, Chengmeng is just on another level right now. Ooh.
Yeah, this is a close, a very smart move by Wang Manyu, hitting close to body.
By Wang Menyu, finding Chengmeng's middle, really jamming her up, not giving her enough time to react.
Talking about Wang Menyu's coach right there, Xiao Zhan from Sichuan province, and he's been very, very closely coaching Wang Menyu. Yesterday, that was such a battle, and I think the teacher, the coach, and the student delivered very well up against Ito Mima, right?
Absolutely.
I mean,
she just
basically
crushed.
Trouncing her.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Four games in a row, four games straight. That was something, again, we didn't expect either, did
we? No, not at all. I mean, Ito has been such a huge threat to the Chinese national team. And to have been, you know, like, I would say destroyed even like that was really unexpected.
Short serve. Back in exchange. Oh, Wang Mei tried very hard to really enhance the level and also the speed, sailing the ball long though.
Wang Mei rushing a little bit in the last one, trying to finish the point too quickly.
Giving Chen Meng an extended lead here. Oh, that is just too good.
Almost,
yeah, close but no cigar. 9-4, a four-point lead here by Chen Meng, and a third ball attack style well executed.
Absolutely.
You're absolutely right, Lily. She's rushing a little bit here, Wang.
Right. I mean, she knows that Chen Meng is so solid out there, so she's trying to find ways to put even more quality and better placement. But, you know, like I said before, it's the higher the risk.
The price you have to pay, right?
Yeah, really. But that's kind of what she needs as well. She needs that sort of quality.
Yeah, Chen Meng was just warned not to touch the table. Short serve. Good chance for Wang Manyu to finish that. Really, she did it with her smash.
Chen Meng's push just drifting a little bit too half long, too high, giving Wang Manyu the opportunity to finish that one.
Landing was not that perfect. One more game point saved by Wang Manyu. Oh, had a difficult time closing out. It's a two-point game now. She needs to think over. But you know that she is so experienced. She knows how to repace herself. Right?
Absolutely. I mean, you can just see the wheels turning in her head right now.
You're an athlete like that. You know that, right? You can read their facial expression.
Absolutely. I mean, you just have to think one step ahead of your opponent every time. Go through all the options of how they're going to serve, how they're going to return, and what you're going to do in response to it.
Short return. Again, another game point saved. This is incredible stuff from this young girl right here. I just said 21 year old. Then she really is aware of the situation, catching up in a row.
Seems like Chen Meng's turn to rush a little bit now. Trying to finish the point too quickly. Needs to find her patience once again.
A few points earned by Wang. Oh, beautiful stuff there. Oh, Chen Meng finally in the middle using her forehand to finish this point. 11-9. Wang Manyu and defending champion Chen Meng, with defending champion Chen Meng taking the first game, 11-9. So, Lily, if I have to ask you to wrap up about a little bit about the first game, what would you say about both of players?
Well, I think in the beginning of the game, Wang Manyu was rushing a little bit. You know, she kind of slowed down a little bit the latter half of the game, whereas Chen Meng tried to finish it too quickly. But to me, oh, wow. That is some intense quality back in right there. So to me, it seems like Wang Mei's quality is higher, per se, but Chen Meng is just so precise in her placement and her accuracy. And it's really, virtually impossible to get anything past her.
Really, and also, she certainly takes an upper hand as far as her experience, right? So to speak, because of her, you know, quote and unquote seniority. And in the end, she was pushed so much in the first game, and she knew how to close it out eventually.
Exactly, yes. When it comes down to those really crucial and critical moments, she knows exactly how to handle herself and what to do.
Mm-hmm. Well, let us know a little bit about your first impression, also your first-hand experience with Wang Manyu. I know that you played against her once or twice.
I did. I had the opportunity to play against Wang Manyu at the Women's World Team Cup,
mm-hmm.
I believe in London, England, a couple years ago, and it was insane. Like, her forehand was just an absolute monster out there.
One, two.
Truly, just for me at least, impossible to block.
Well, it's a learning experience and learning process. I'm sure, you know, it's something you would take it as as your asset as well.
Yep.
But she's certainly, you know, she comes a long way, and she really is getting there to be felt very strongly now.
Absolutely.
Ooh. Oh, short. Wow, look at the placement from this young lady here in red.
And that was already an incredible recovery by Chen Meng, even getting back that short net. But Wang Manyu just too strong to finish it off with her forehand.
Mm-hmm. Top spin cross court. Without yelling, she is on fire as well. A good start in game two, making it a 3-point lead here for her. I spoke to Chen Meng yesterday after her victory over Sun Yingsha. She was saying that, it's just a good day. And I said, you were insane, totally. She said,
She's too humble.
Yeah, exactly. She said, it's just my lucky day, and somehow I felt that everything I hit, I got it. It was, sheer luck.
Yeah.
Again, you know,
toning
down.
Total modesty for her. But in reality, you know, that's hours and hours of hard work and training.
Oh, that she puts
into. And dedication to the sport.
Yeah. Wow, this speedy backhand exchange. Again, Wang Manyu really has improved her quality in this game.
Absolutely. Like I said before, I feel like Wang Manyu's quality is just a bit higher than Chen Meng. Chen Meng needs to find a way to perhaps take Wang Manyu wide out to her forehand, make her move, get her off balance a little bit so she can't use that high quality.
Good coverage from Wang Manyu. Absolutely beautiful. She was all over.
Absolutely. And Chen Meng still bringing her out to the wide corner, but Wang Manyu's height really providing her that advantage there. You know, just to reach out and recover every single ball thrown at her. Look at that. That is sheer determination and will.
She indeed is forcing Chen Meng to really take all these high risks right now. And then again, they are too risky sometimes. You know, I feel that in the late part of the first game, Wang's confidence is back, actually. And also, she feels that she could do that after really catching up, narrowly losing the first game. And then she believes herself more and more so into this game.
Absolutely. I think she's on a momentum right now, really being the aggressor of this game.
We haven't seen Ma Ling yet. And we saw Wang Manyu's coach, Xiao Zhan. We haven't caught Chen Meng's coach, Ma Ling, yet, the former London Games, Olympic Games, actually, singles champion, gold medalist. He has been working very closely with Chen Meng, helping her. Chen Meng far away from the table, launching her forehand, but a close-to-body shot by Wang Manyu is simply too good.
Wow, that was a spectacular rally. It seems like Wang Manyu has pushed Chen Meng a little far from the table. You know, that's not where she wants to be. And Wang Manyu's accuracy this game has been really impeccable, finding all of Chen Meng's middles.
Chen Meng has been tested now. Wow, that is too good with her fake move right there successfully.
Wang Manyu's receive just popping up a little bit too high, allowing Chen Meng the opportunity to finish it off with a great backhand flip.
She needs to stop her opponent's momentum. Wow, this is just good stuff there from both sides until Wang Maiyi hitting the ball into the net. One has to remember, Lily, correct me if I'm wrong, it is more than just speedy. It's also very spinny right there.
Oh,
right?
Absolutely. There's so much spin on each shot out there. And it's not just speed as well. It's the change of rhythm, the pace, the placement. There's so much you have to take into account in every rally.
I enjoy that. I mean, I actually understand that your coach, Jeffrey Zun, told me you also enjoy long rallies. You also enjoy long rallies, right? And you're very good at long rallies. And
I do. Oh my gosh.
Lucky ball there for Chen. Earning her another point. So tell us about this kind of a, you know, joy from long rallies. What do you get out of it? Tell me about it.
I mean, I just think I've enjoyed it ever since I was young. You know, it's just when the ball goes for a long time, you just feel
back
so
and
much
forth.
Adrenaline, yeah.
Adrenaline is the word.
Ooh, again. And Wang Maiyi rushing a little bit too much.
She knows it. Talking to herself, just alleviating the pressure she has. Talking about pressure. It really is unbelievable for both players.
Chen Meng has really bounced back this game. Wang Maiyi needs to be a little bit more patient, find the balls that are a good opportunity to finish it instead of just going straight for it.
Seven apiece. Oh, this is good. Well executed from Chen Meng, third ball attack style. Didn't give her opponent a chance to answer.
Chen Meng now taking the lead. It seems like just a few seconds ago, Wang Maiyi was, you know, had a commanding lead before.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is good landing from Chen Meng. Half long, making Wang Maiyi very uncomfortable.
Absolutely, and Chen Meng has really changed the placement of her service as well, serving it wide out to Wang Maiyi's forehand so she can't really step in to use her lethal backhand flip, giving her a lot of discomfort and what to do.
You can tell the experience definitely pays off here.
Mm, totally.
Trading by two.
Seven, nine.
Wang has a chance to even a score if she can really score twice here with her service points.
Chen Meng rushing a little bit to finish this rally too quickly.
Wang is also pacing herself, thinking through before executes. Mm,
oh, wow.
Yeah, you're right. Chen Meng is rushing a little bit in a hurry.
That was actually a great opportunity for just not finding exact right timing or spin.
Yeah, before executing, you just have to be really very, very careful. You need to read well, but then again, easier said than done. Everything happens in that split second.
Yeah, it's really insanely quick.
Wow, the backhand flick there.
Mm-hmm. Very smart tactic by Chen Meng, continuing to serve wide to the forehand. Wang Maiyi stepping in with her backhand, but not being able to put as much quality on it, allowing Chen Meng to really take the initiative.
How do you play?
One game point held by Chen Meng. She could serve it out. Wow, that's a beautiful and wise return from Wang Maiyi, cross court. She knows it.
What a spectacular return by Wang Maiyi. And look at how much that means to her with that cho so low to the ground.
Absolutely.
She really predicted that serve.
And the first game was set apart by 2 points. And by the same token, this one is going to be the same case. Chen Meng taking the initiative. Wanted to receive it. Strong. Sailing the ball out. Now Wang Manyu has a game point for a change. Wow, I believe Chen Meng really is very smart in the sense just placing it again, half short, half long, forcing your opponent to make a mistake.
Right. Oh my gosh. And such a great placement as well, straight to Wang Manyu's middle.
The placement of Chen Meng absolutely is precise. Wang Manyu, of course, knows about it.
Wang Manyu with no hesitation whatsoever. Just an absolute ripping backhand shot. Too fast for Chen Meng to react.
Yeah. Wang Manyu actually called a timeout. Short. Netting out from Chen Meng. Wang Manyu, thanks to that miss. The defending champion is definitely not going to let anything like that in second game happen. She is so determined right here with her smashes. And when you talk to the defending champion, as I did yesterday, and she feels that, you know, history is there to be remade or rewritten, everything, but she says she doesn't think about that much. All she needs to right now is to focus on her next opponent, next game, next match.
Right, and that is a great mindset to have, because oftentimes the more you think about the results, the more that affects your game and lets the pressure get to you. You really have to stay in the present moment.
As you once said, actually, table tennis definitely is a mind game, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. Especially against players of this caliber who know each other so well. You know, their strategy, their tactics are changing every few points.
Talking about changes, Chen Meng really had a good start. And in the third, right now, she is enjoying a 3-point lead, maybe a 4. Yes, indeed, making it a 4-point lead. What a great start Chen Meng is enjoying.
Chen Meng really being the aggressor this game, really imposing her shots now, putting more quality on the ball, bringing Wang Manyu so far from the table and finishing it with such determination.
Let ball now.
Wang Manyu yet to be on board in this game.
Ball one.
She is even more hungry than Chen Meng to want to have this title, and that will be her international first international title. Especially at such a level. Chen Meng setting up beautifully, turning around her body to hit, yet netting out.
Again, Chen Meng rushing a little bit too much this point, trying to finish the point too quickly. You know, she's really had that advantage in the long rallies. I think if she really paces herself instead of trying to finish it off, she has a really good chance.
Oh, that was a poor miss from Wang Manyu.
Great serve by Wang Manyu, really surprising Chen Meng, giving herself an opportunity, but just unfortunately could not execute it.
And she was disappointed with that one. But again, very difficult for Chen Meng to really loop it half long, half short.
Right. Especially those serves that just come right off the table near the white line. It's really so hard to judge whether it's short or long, whether you should push it or go for it.
Chen Meng, when I first ran into her, it was like in Suzhou China Open. She took the title in both women's singles and doubles, and that was her really first time to be known by the international world. And then up to this point, she's gone.
Ooh.
She's improved so much.
That was an incredible backhand rally by Chen Meng, changing the placement so far out wide to Wang Meiyu's forehand. That's really what she needs to do. Oh, and a service mistake by Chen Meng. I think we've seen two so far this match. Quite a rare sight to see by Chen Meng, or really any player at this level. Now that was a fantastic backhand flip by Chen Meng. Wang Meiyu's drop short just popping up a little bit too high. Chen Meng going in to finish it so quickly, so swiftly. And another half long serve by Wang Meiyu. Chen Meng misjudging the distance again. Sailing the ball a little bit too long.
But you can tell that Chen Meng, after painfully losing the last game, picking up her rhythm again.
Absolutely.
Trying to make things happen in her favor. Wow, this is good stuff from Wang Meiyu, being pushed away from the table, yet launching her back at cross court.
And Chen Meng doing such a great job as well of moving Wang Meiyu all around the table. Look at those corners. Any other player in the world would not be able to retrieve that, but Wang Meiyu just bounces back even stronger.
Oh boy. So that's why she's one of the players, female, on the female side from China, actually, women's side, who is not afraid of being away from the table, launching her topspin at all.
Absolutely, and her height really giving her an advantage in that.
Mm-hmm.
Being able to retrieve balls that are so wide out.
Chen Meng, 3 points away from taking another game, giving herself a 2-1 lead. She's been tested for sure.
This time, Chen Meng doing a great job of reading the half-long serve, looping it and placing it to Wang Meiyu's backhand.
Yeah, willing to really be engaged and willing to take the shots.
Right, take the initiative.
Oh! Selling it long, she knows about it, a little bit disappointed. That was a bad miss, or just, you know,
a bit
barely,
of a missed opportunity, right?
Exactly. A costly miss there, but she still has 2 point lead here. Wang Meiyu to receive. Oh boy. Reading it very, very correctly and launching the topspin right there.
Absolutely. Chen Meng really wanting to surprise Wang Meiyu there, but Wang Meiyu just being so prepared for that shot.
Well, we have sort of like an electric current sound. Stopping for a moment, let's continue. Again, a gutsy return from Wang Meiyu. leveling the score now.
Wamai really putting a lot of pressure on Chamung. You know, creating these unforced errors from her that you usually don't see.
So far, you know, up to this point, two games completed, and the third one, including this one we're talking about, basically you cannot really tell the two apart.
No.
Seesaw battle going on.
So closely contested.
11-9, 13-11. Now 9 apiece here in the third. Wow, this is too good, setting herself up. Chamung getting a game point here, finishing with her forehand.
A spectacular move by Chamung. Really taking the initiative and just no hesitation. Her incredible forehand, parallel, so deep on the table.
And she knows it. She's happy with that smash right there and drive. One game point in her pocket. Oh, that's a bad return, and she knows it. Misreading that serve, and also popping up half long.
Really surprised by Wamai's serve, thinking it was backspin, and it was really the opposite. Giving a really easy smash to Wamai.
I know. Got a decision, topspin serve right there, really to get this chance to finish it off. 10 apiece. Couldn't be closer. Oh. Both recovering well. Ah, Chamung wanting to use her backhand to push parallel, sending the ball into the net, giving Wong a chance to finish this game off.
And a beautiful recovery by Wamai as well. Chamung just hitting the top of the net. Usually that breaks your opponent's rhythm a little bit, but Wamai was just up for the challenge. And Chamung just rushing a little bit too much on that last shot, trying to finish it.
Boy, these two, shoulder by shoulder, net by net, really, really making the other very, very difficult to achieve any point. Wow, this is really, again, courageous smash there by Chamung.
And this time, Chamung was ready for that serve. She knew exactly what was coming. And look at how wide Chamung really needs to go in order to win a point.
Because she knows that, actually. The other is tall enough, and also with her long arm, to reach out, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
11-all. This is absolutely breathtaking. Oh, this is too good. Acceleration of her power from her backhand diagonal cross court from Wang Manyu.
So much quality from Wang Manyu's backhand as well. I mean, she's known for her incredibly powerful forehand, but it seems she's really worked and improved on placing even more quality in her backhand.
I know.
Just too much for Chamung to handle at the moment.
No obvious shortcoming, and that's what she said during the last 9 months of closed-door training under the pandemic situation. She says she's been working ferociously hard in all categories.
Clearly paid off.
Whoa, again, our defending champion. That's a smart and gutsy decision.
So brave from Chamung, just no hesitation whatsoever. Still, wow, just spectacular stuff out here.
Truly, truly incredible stuff. 10 all, 11 apiece, 12 all now. How far can we push? Depending on these two ladies here. Wow, again, great placement from the defending champion. Three-time champion here. She really is on fire as well.
And Chamung finally finding that wide forehand, wide enough that Wang Manyu cannot return it this time. Oh my goodness.
You just have to create a lot of wide angles in order to survive here, or Wang Manyu will come back to haunt
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. I mean, Zhang just really knows how to step it up an extra notch in these crucial moments.
Quality performance right here being presented. Chen Meng, a game point again. She got it with her forehand smash. But no matter what, both sides are really true winners.
Wider than the corner even.
And folks, we're really witnessing some historical moment here with both players displaying the best they can in this women's singles final of 2020 International Table Tennis Federation Grand Finals. Wang Manyu here in red, taking on her opponent, the defending champion of China as well, Chen Meng in black. And I'm your commentator, Wang Dong. With me, my working partner, Lily Chan, the top female player from the United States. And Lily, really, at this stage, I guess, it's still a mind game, right? I mean, not that Wang Manyu doesn't have any shot at all to come back.
Mm-hmm. Their levels are very, very close. It really just comes down to whether you want to go for it or not. And Wang Manyu really being the aggressor of this game.
We're talking about close. Can it be closer, really? The three games in a row in the past, or the previous three, each game was set apart by only 2 points.
Yeah, really can't get any closer.
Again, parallel shot from Chen Meng, making it work. Oh God, again from defending champion right here. Her backhand now is also like whipping through.
So lightning fast, it's really just a rocket.
If she wins, she cannot just tell me that she has another lucky day. It's just definitely because of her ferociously hardworking training and so forth.
Absolutely.
She's just been, you know, again, modest. Look at the way Chen Meng blocks back.
I mean, her placement is really just impeccable. Her anticipation of where the ball is coming and where to go next with it. And Wang Manyu has great quality as well, but she needs to take into account the placement. If you go straight to Chen Meng's hand, I mean, that you might as well give her the point.
Indeed, indeed. Well, I'm sure she is not dejected in any sense. She is still very much on fire, and she knows about it. As we said, only the previous three games, each game was set up by 2 points, and nothing wrong with her, really. Right. She is really on the mark. In the middle, there again, pushing her opponent with the forehand smash from Wang Manyu.
I mean, you're really showcasing her forehand in this rally. So much quality.
Chen Meng again, pacing herself.
Ooh.
3-5.
Unforced error there by Wang Manyu.
Mm-hmm. Look at your ground, they are covering. Unbelievable, all the angles. Again, Chen Meng coming on top with her backhand, sending that angle there.
And Chen Meng's angle has been so astounding this entire match. Wang Manyu is so great at retrieving almost every ball, but Chen Meng just really can
step it up. Oh my God, Wang is athletic enough, right?
Absolutely.
Trying to cover her ground. Long serve, backhand exchange.
That was a great backhand rally by both. Wamaru being so stable, finally imposing her aggression.
Yeah, she needs to stay close to her opponent as much as she can. Perhaps even having the shot there that she needs to take to overpass or surpass her opponent. Again, this kind of a mistakes really should be avoided. Too costly, and she knows that. An easy point earned by Chen Meng again.
Yeah. But Chen Meng's placement of her service is also very well intended.
Mm-hmm.
Well intended.
Spinny as well.
Continuing to serve wide out to Wamaru's forehand, short forehand, not allowing her to step in and use her backhand slip.
Mm-hmm. Long serve, that's beautiful. Backhand exchange there, pushing through Chen Meng.
And Chen Meng really has been great at winning the points on her services. She's really making Wamaru second guess whether it's short forehand or long backhand.
Mm-hmm. Just love the way she places the ball, really. I mean, with so many variations going on.
Exactly. Wow.
Well, look at Chen Meng also reaching out, but credit to Wang Manyu. All the angles created by her.
Now, great angle placement by Wamaru. So wide out to Chamon's back end first. Oh my gosh. And a crossover forehand.
We saw this from Wang Baiyu. Now we've seen this from Chen Meng. They're both just so athletic.
Absolutely.
Covering so much of their ground. A chance to finish this point, but recovering very well from Chen Meng's side. Oh, Ito Mima. Is also watching. Why not? It's his chance also to learn, to observe, and also absorb some new knowledge and so forth. Because after all, these two players on court are her rivals anyway.
Right.
This is by far the largest lead created by Chen Meng. A 4-point cushion, making it 3 now. Wow, this is good. Step forward just to finish that point. Cross court.
Very gutsy move by Wamaru.
Mm-hmm.
Chen Meng has really been containing Wamaru short to the forehand, but that was a fantastic last minute flip.
Chen Meng time out.
Chen Meng calls a timeout. Short serve. Wow. Ferociously attacking Chen Meng's forehand, pushing it really deep, Wang Manyu.
Right, Wang Manyu really taking the lead in this rally, you know, dictating the pace. Now she is the one being, you know, playing down the line of Chen Meng's forehand, placing the angles.
Making it a 1-point business here. Oh! Lucky ball for Chen Meng, though. She knows it.
But still a great rally by Chen Meng.
Absolutely.
You know, changing the direction to Wamaru's forehand, that's really what she needs to do. If she just continues to place it to Wamaru's backhand, Wamaru's quality is just incredible.
Now, Chen has got 2 game points to finish her business, if possible, to give herself a 3-1 lead on scoreboard overall. Can she deliver? Wow, again, luck is on her side, being apologetic. Her teammate, Wang Manyu, in red of China as well. Chen Meng so far taking the lead here.
Oh my goodness.
A look at the way from defense to offense, Chen Meng attacking ferociously, earning that point in game five.
Truly an unbelievable start to the fifth game. Wow, Chunmeng's angle just still being incredibly wide. Wanmari doing everything she can. Chunmeng too good out there.
Forcing her opponent to be on the ground, on the floor. Chunmeng relentlessly hardworking. Wow, another point. She is totally on fire. Let me tell you, right now, her top form is totally, totally invincible almost.
Absolutely. She is on a roll right now. Constantly changing super wide to Wanmari's forehand. Wanmari needs to do the same. Whoever changes first to the forehand has won most of the points.
Wang Manyu attacking. Ah, again, Chunmeng. Good placement right there. And also thanks to a lucky ball, she has scored 4 points in a row.
And Chunmeng is just a wall. I mean, you really can't get anything past her at this point.
This is like a three-time charm, or more than three-time charm. I mean, this is crazy for Chunmeng right now. Got many lucky balls in a sense, right? Seems that it means something. Making it actually 4 points in a row. Perhaps it's meant to be that way. Really, she's getting there. And also, the luck is also on the defending champion's side.
Right, and Wanmari doing everything she can. So much quality and so wide as well, but Chunmeng still being there. How does she do it?
Unbelievable. This is really Wang Banyu facing a war right here. A strong, well-defending champion. 5 points in a row. The momentum totally has shifted.
Yeah. I'll bet Wang Banyu wish she had a timeout to break Chunmeng's rhythm at this point. There's really no stopping her. She can't miss.
Also notice that Sun Yingsha is there watching as well. Sun Yingsha being actually trounced by Chunmeng yesterday in four straight games. And she probably saying, wow, no wonder, you know, I was actually badly beaten in a sense. But actually Sun Yingsha didn't, not a terrible job, bad job at all.
Not at all.
But it's just that Chunmeng is too strong right now.
Absolutely. Sun Yingsha does not need to feel bad about her performance. Chunmeng is just out of this world.
Oh boy. Stands out completely. Sailing the ball on, losing another point. Wang Banyu, you cannot really afford to give away these easy points. A comfortable cushion led by Chunmeng now.
Chunmeng's incredible retrieval of that with her forehand, placing it even wider out to Wang Banyu. I mean, again, I just have to say her placement this entire match has been impeccable. Wow. Absolutely fierce forehand by Chunmeng. So much spin and quality. Looks like a side spin block by Chunmeng right there. I mean, she's just on a roll.
Chunmeng only 2 points away from making history here to become a four-time grand final champion. Now the championship point here for Chunmeng. My God, the largest margin. And Chunmeng knows that she needs to be just focused to finish it off. Long serve. Sometimes at this stage, you tend to think about, you know, a little bit about the result, right? When you have such a big lead, right?
Right, right. Just loosening up just a little bit.
But she still has 7 championship points here. Well, it ain't over until it's over. She knows that losing another point or another championship point saved by Wang Manyu.
And Wang Manyu is still fighting really hard despite being down 10-1.
Mm-hmm.
She's really the true definition of a fighter out here.
Oh, yeah. She's only 21. Daunting. Ooh. Relentless from Wang Manyu, forcing Chen Meng to really think over. She got no timeout anymore. We know that. Can we see a turnaround? This is it. Chen Meng finally with her back and flick, making that championship point become true.